guys, welcome back to the channel. I just wanted to actually do this video. This video is very random, I should say. I don't really have like a full structure for what I want to talk about in this video, but these are some of the books that I read when I was going from, you know, grade school, like middle school to high school to senior year. And these are not like my favorite ones, or these are not like super inspiring ones, but these are just some of the books that I found back home, and I took a thumbnail for it, and I was like, oh, you know what, I'll just talk about these books. Obviously, I do have a lot more other books as well that I have read throughout the years, so I'll just kind of go through really like a summary of all the books that I've read and what I've liked in them. And I thought of giving like a rating of all the books, but then I think I'll give a rating. I'm very sorry if you can hear the fan. It's actually, the problem was the sunlight for the past 2 days has been beautiful, but I've been so busy with, I think this is the first semester where I'm so overloaded and overworked with coursework that I have so much to do. I don't have enough days. I think by the end of April, I'm super, super busy because I have, every day I have about like 3 submissions or a test and 2 submissions. It's just very hectic, so this video is a little random. I thought I'd just sit down and talk because I didn't get a lot of like recorded footage throughout the week. But today the weather became instantly really cold. It wasn't this cold, and suddenly the sunlight went, and this is at the peak hour, but there's no sunlight right now. It's all cloudy and it's really cold, so I had to kind of do like a soft aesthetic setting. So let's start the video. I think everybody has read Anna Blyden growing up. I think I used to remember when we had library period, we were also showing movies, but I would always go and pick up a book and sit down and study. I was not like a nerd to read, but I just loved reading books because I'm a huge book reader. So I think I just loved the fact that I got to read so many books, like unlimited books. So I remember reading Anna Blyden, obviously. I think it was Famous Five and Secret Seven and Nancy Drew, Goosebumps, and so many other. I think these were just like the base of my childhood. And growing up, the one book that I was so reluctant to start was Harry Potter, because the moment I saw there were 7 books, I was like, oh no, I don't want to read. And I remember I think it was 6th grade when I was just flipping through the first 2 pages for a full 2 weeks. I couldn't go past the second page. I was like, oh, so boring. And one day I just sat down and oh my god, that was the best experience of my life. Moving on, I think Harry Potter is obviously everybody's favorite book. I'm one of those though, one of those souls that prefer reading the books than watching the movies. I don't think I've watched any of the movies that have been made from books. I prefer reading the books. So Harry Potter, the first book that I ever read was the Inkheart Trilogy. The Inkheart Trilogy is actually the first series, I think, book series I read after Harry Potter, because usually I do read single books. And it was a very different book because Inkheart wasn't as famous when I was reading it. Not a lot of people knew what it was about, and I remember carrying it to school. It was a really thick book. It's not thin, it's a really thick book. So people usually be like, oh my god, there are no pictures in it, you know, how kids were back in school. And I enjoyed the fact, and I think one of the best things that the author has done has written quotes before every chapter, which are really relatable because, you know, you just kind of see and you're like, oh, I know this from this book. Oh, I know this from this book. And it's just really nice. Oh, I also read The Little Woman and The Little Princess growing up. So all of that. I think my favorite book personally is The Ink Death out of the 3. I love Mo's character in it. I love how everybody's so matured, and I think it's just like a superhero kind of story. It's not a very in the beginning when you read it, it doesn't really attract you to it. It was for me personally, but I loved reading it. It was amazing. I would like to give it like, I think, an 8 out of a 10. Yeah. Synopsis of Inkheart. Inkheart is actually a story about a father who has the ability to read out characters from the book. So if it's Winnie the Pooh, the way he reads it out loud, who can come out of a book in the real world. But as of now, he doesn't know how to put the characters back in the book. So that is a little Hunger Games. Oh, Hunger Games was the hype of the time, but I don't remember anyone talking about it, to me especially. So when Hunger Games was released, my sibling bought the book for me, and I remember when I was reading it, I think it was the middle of the book, and I was like, wait, I don't want her to die, because I did not know Hunger Games was another trilogy. And I was like, you know what, wait, let me just check the last page. And I checked the last page, and I was like, oh, okay, she's not gonna die. So, and he's not gonna die, so I was like, okay. And I just continued reading the book. After that, I got to know there were two other books, Catching Fire and Mockingjay. But Hunger Games was obviously a life changer. I love the food bits in the Hunger Games books. I love how they include, you know, the description of this food and everything. I love that. Hunger Games was obviously a 10 out of a 10. I think it was an amazing book. It was, I think, a little mature book for me, I think. It was finally a book where death was talked about. Harry Potter was obviously, I know, it was like a place where your favorite characters died, but this was just like a different kind of a eye-opener. So yeah, I think Hunger Games. And I used to read a lot of books online because at that time, or I used to do the library. I also read a lot of encyclopedia because my mom and dad got it for my eldest siblings. So I never had the... I was a more of a sporty kind of person. I was always in my school sports team. And the next books that I'm going to be including are all of the books that are just going to go... There are no particular order. It's just books that I read. So I think I read Warcross. That book was the first science thriller, and it was science five book, and I was like, oh my god. And unfortunately for me, the second part did not come out when I finished the first part. It was like in December, maybe, so it was coming out the next year, October, and I was like so stuck by that book. I was like, that book was amazing. It took technology to this weird part where a very scary reality. It took technology to that very scary reality. And I would obviously give Warcross, I'll give it a 9.5 because I really want to read the second book. And as soon as I do, I think I will update you guys on it. The next thriller that I read this year after coming back from college, I finally had my leisure reading after three years, was The City of Bones by Michael Connelly. Oh my god, it's a thriller, I think, yeah. It is, it builds up your, you know, it builds up that anticipation to find out the ending. And oh my god, the ending was the most disappointing. For me personally, I did not like the ending. It did not give any clarity to the situation, to the book. It did not give any, it was not like, oh, kind of, you know, that. It was just like, oh, like that. You know, the exclamation marks that usually books should deliver. It wasn't that. I did not personally like it a lot, but at the same time, I loved how the guy, the police officer, is so loyal to his duties. So I'd like to give that book a 7 out of 10. Just the ending could have been better and a bit more explained, I think. Yeah, I'm talking like I'm a worldwide famous author. The next book that I read was Gone Girl. Oh my god. Gone Girl, for me as a kid, was the most terrifying book I read. I was so scared of the girl. I was so scared of her. And I was so scared for the husband. And then I got to know that the husband is cheating. But oh my god, the way she's planned everything, she's like a serial killer. I don't know. She was so scary. I remember I was being so... I think I took the longest time reading the book because at every page I was like, no. Oh my god, no. And I was so scared. I was just like, no, what? It's a 10 out of 10, though. The book is a 10 out of 10. The book was an amazing book. The ending was perfect. I loved how she explained everything. And the one part was like the part where he's never had a father that he wants to become a good father for his child. It's a really nice part, though, because there's so many abusive parents out there who end up raising children that are either as abusive as them when they get married into a family because they don't know what else, how loving somebody should be, or they are as loving as they could be because they know what not having love is like. And that book was amazing. I love the strategic planning that she has. I love how they have POVs for both of them. And later on, I got to know with Ultimatum to Movie. So I really, really loved that book. It was amazing. The next book is this. Okay, to be honest, this is my favorite book so far. This is a book that I would recommend to anyone, a new reader or just anybody. The Martian. Oh my god. When my sister got this book, in this beginning pages, it's very scientific, okay? So I'm a science student, but I was not like a very studious person up until high school. So I think I was just like, oh, I don't want to read about it. But oh my god, The Martian is so funny, so sarcastic, so chill, and the person is so optimistic that even after almost dying about 5 times into the book, he's just so bent on finding solutions in life, which actually gives you a different perspective of life, how you should really, you know, work on your optimism. I'm a fairly optimistic person. I'm a very positive person, but people around me, when they're negative or they're just like, oh, can't find a solution to this problem, or my god, life is like this, I don't really relate to them. Martian was amazing. It taught me so much about how if I'm stranded ever in Mars, I can connect to NASA through the radio, or how can I grow my own plants, and how can I drive my rover to the MAWE. I think it's a 100,000 over 10. This book was an amazing book. This book was awesome. I love the last part where he's finally like, I'm home. Like, he's finally realized that he's back. He's going back to Earth. And I love the teammates. I loved how they had such a good bonding. I just love everything about that book. Diary of a Wimpy Kid. I think Diary of a Wimpy Kid was read by everyone. I don't think I've read all of the books of Diary of a Wimpy Kid, but I've read some and I also watched some because I remember loving the Wimpy Kid. Well, I don't know what the Wimpy Kid is. I just love the hand drawings that the stick figures that the author has made. I just love it. It's an amazing book. Wimpy Kid is, again, 10 on 10. Wimpy Kid is so cool. And I love how every time there's some problems and it's like the protagonist acts in a, I hope, I'm sorry for the name. The protagonist acts in a weird way or a negative way, especially to Rowley and everything. And then in the end, it's always a nice ending. So I like that. That's a nice ending to all the stories. Because as kids, I don't think anybody wants to read about, you know, real life situations that don't have a happy ending. Oh, I also, by the way, did read Cinderella and Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, Sleeping Beauty. I read all of these books growing up. So yeah. Growing up, I loved the encyclopedias that had that had dinosaurs in them. I loved them. I loved everything about dinosaurs. I loved reading about them, and I loved how you could find, there were so many different types of dinosaurs, and just, I think everything about it. I loved reading about dinosaurs, and as a kid, I didn't really understand encyclopedias, and even though these encyclopedias were really simplified for kids, I just remember turning up to the page of the dinosaur with the only pictures and a few like definitions and given information, and I just like stare at it, and I was like, oh my god, this was the biggest dinosaur, water dinosaur or flying dinosaur. I was like, okay. The next book is Sherlock Holmes. Okay, Sherlock Holmes is, to be honest, oh my god. Sherlock Holmes, oh, now that I see this, I just realized I've not read both the parts of Sherlock Holmes. I've read only half of it in last year in lockdown. I was with my, I fell in love with the character Sherlock, and I loved how John Watson was there. And Sherlock Holmes, another, I think, 1,000 on 10. It's such a amazing book that it actually makes you kind of want to become a Sherlock Holmes, and you start like going investigating everybody, and you start like kind of looking at somebody and trying to work out where they've come from. Oh my god, how many siblings do they have? How many dogs do they have? It's a nice series, and every ending of the series, I think we watched all the 4 seasons, every ending of the series was in surprise. I remember the episode where the girl is she has her phone logged, and Sherlock has to figure out the password, and I was like, oh, this is the answer, oh, this is the answer. And when the ending came, it was like, I am Sherlocked. I was like, no. And when he died, I think I almost cried. I don't cry anytime, but yeah. Another one book that I want to talk about is The Chicken Soup for the Unthinkable Soul. The one that I have is this one. It's oh my God, it makes you feel so blessed and grateful for all the things that you have in life. And just because God gave you everything, you don't have the right to be atrocious, arrogant, and show, and just, you know, be prideful about the fact that God gave you everything. You need to know your privileges. But I loved the chicken soup for the unsinkable soul. I think I got this, I was gifted this book. I actually lost my best friend in fifth grade. She died in a car accident, and so when I was reading this book, I was just so shocked. I think I skipped a few chapters where there was a person with a little disability or things, and I told my mom about it or someone, and they were like, no, you need to read about it, you need to know, because running away from reality is never an option, and you need to know how great, how privileged you are and how others are not, and because you have the ability to make their world better or to change the world for them, you should do that. So I think this is another book that just really opened my mind. Anyway guys, I think that is it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please do click the like button and subscribe to my channel. And also, I really I think I've gotten to know that there are a few COVID cases that are increasing day by day. They're spiking up high, and there are a few cities and countries where they are implemented lockdown 2.0 or night curfews. So please guys, be safe, wear a mask, save yourself, social distance, stay in your homes. I know it's really difficult. I know sometimes people really, even for, I know a lot of people, students for studying, they like to go to cafes and everything, but please avoid it to the extent that you can. But this year, I hope you can make the most out of it. And please stay in your homes and take care of your health. And if you are tested positive, don't hide it from anybody. Stay quarantine yourself and don't be afraid.